Yeah, in this particular study, actually.
In short, iCardiac is in the business of making sure new pharmaceuticals won't kill you.
It looks like a number of people with software on their desks typing away. But in reality, what we're doing here is cutting-edge cardiac safety research that's more advanced than anything else in the world right now.
Alex Zapasochny is president and co-founder of iCardiac. His company uses complex algorithms to analyze electrocardiograms from patients who participate in clinical drug trials. Analysts at iCardiac look for irregularities that could signal potentially lethal cardiac side effects.
So it's medicine and very advanced math put together. And a lot of things which are very exciting these days are really about that. It's two different disciplines coming together to look at problems in a unique way.
But beyond the innovative science, what the fast-growing iCardiac represents is a burgeoning upstate success story.
And this is where it all began. Back in 2006, Zapasochny and two other business partners came here to the University of Rochester Medical Center's Technology Transfer Office. They were looking for a promising technology that they could turn into a profitable business.
I think there's a common misconception about how university research really becomes a successful commercial company. And that misconception is that the scientists who actually help to create or discover something new are often going to be the best ones to actually bring that to the marketplace.
Zapasochny says the company's two scientific co-founders have been instrumental to iCardiac's early success, but he says the firm wouldn't be where it is today without a team of business people leading the charge. Zapasochny, who originally made his name with his own systems security company, says it's not just about building the better mousetrap, it's about having someone to take it to the next level.
What this area, upstate, really lacks is not great scientific talent. We have many, many amazing scientists doing tremendous things, and that part of it only seems to be growing. What we do lack, though, are individuals who have actually successfully, or even unsuccessfully for that matter, taken something from infancy, a research project from infancy, and made it into a company. And that's really what we need more and more of in this region.
That and money. Zapasochny says bridging the so-called valley of death between the lab bench and the marketplace is a serious challenge for upstate tech startups. For iCardiac, it took a little bit of help from New York State and an early partnership with drug giant Pfizer to land key funding from venture capital.
The early stage funding allows you the time you need to have all of those serendipitous moments that you need in a young company. And then those are the moments where your company hopefully starts taking off.
For fledgling tech companies to take off in Rochester, Zapasochny says there needs to be a greater tolerance for risk and ultimately for failure. But with big money bets the exception to the local rule, Zapasochny hopes iCardiac can be a point of inspiration for local entrepreneurs. The model of cashing in on the region's wealth of bright ideas is a model he plans to replicate.
Once iCardiac, we hope, ends up a success story and we're looking for something else, I and my fellow co-founders have no doubt that there's some amazing technologies that we can basically start over with again and do the same thing that we're doing with iCardiac now.
Zapasochny hopes other upstate entrepreneurs and investors can find a similar way to do the same. Reporting from the Innovation Trail, I'm Zack Seward.
If you don't have it initially to develop it, but part of what's interesting about entrepreneurship is oftentimes you're dealing with such